We'll start with the attendance and the certificate module. I am Vani Agrawal from IIT DAVV Indore, and he is Rajdeep Pinge from DAIICT Gandhinagar. This is the FDP coordinator's interface. Whenever the FDP coordinator logs in, he'll be seeing the list of all the workshops, and when he'll be clicking on any of the particular workshop, then he'll be able to see the list of dates for which the schedules for the particular workshop has been assigned. On clicking on any of the particular dates, we can see the details of the participants and their absent and the present. In attendance module, we have different views for the FDP coordinator. The FDP coordinator can view the attendance of the participants, and he can also update the attendance. The RCC coordinator can only view the attendance and generate the Excel report. And the principal delivery manager can generate the reports based on the filtering conditions. Now we move on to the FDP course coordinators module. We can see whenever the FDP coordinator logs in, he'll be able to see the list of the dates for which the schedules for the particular workshops are being done. And whenever he'll be pressing it on the blue button, he'll be able to see he can update the attendance. And when he's updating the attendance, the button will turn to green. And after the update, he can see whatever he has updated. There are also gray buttons which are disabled. The gray buttons are for the past sessions, and the blue buttons are for the active sessions. The admin, the FDP coordinator downloads the attendance sheet, and he'll get the signature of all the participants, and then he'll be uploading it. This is the attendance sheet. He can upload the attendance sheet, and then he can view the uploaded attendance sheet. Now we'll move on to the remote center coordinator's interface.
So starting with the remote center, the basic objective of remote center coordinator is to manage the remote center. So remote center can see the attendance for that particular remote center. So as you can see, the list of workshops that the remote center coordinator sees. And a similar interface is there. Just the thing is that instead of the editable checkboxes there, right now we have just the display attendance button. So only the attendance gets displayed in this part. Then one more feature is there, that the attendance report
will be filled manually or something automatically.
The earlier module, what she explained in there, the attendance will be filled manually by the
FCC. You didn't have anything like biometric interface or something. They can fill 15 means 15, 20 means 20. There is no counter check, right?
No, that is why we have that attendance sheet where the participants have to sign that attendance sheet, and we can verify it so that there should be no discrepancy.
So it is a manual work.
Yeah.
No. Okay. It gets worse than that. Okay. Because what the manual team does is, okay, wherever they can also look at the AVUCA footage, snapshots. Okay. Mm. And then they go back to the remote center and say, "Ki Baba, you are saying that 15 people attended, but I see only 4 heads." Okay, so that much monitoring has to do, because the earlier workshops, okay, were run with government funding, so that the remote center used to get money per participant. Okay, so they will enroll so many, and nobody will be there. There were cases where the students were asked to attend, because our people asked 4 head hai, so next time 15 head bane, wo sab student the. Okay, so they're cheating to collect money from the government. So there's a huge thing was coming. Once we go into the funded mode category, I don't think all these things is necessary. But this is a
pass. But it is always good thing that you can integrate the biometrics.
Not biometrics. What I asked them to do is, the biometrics we can't insist at every remote center. Okay, so what I asked them to do is, whatever is the ye jo hai tumhara signature, which form is uploaded, that I can do image analysis and find out how many have signed. Okay, that can be done at least.
They can take 11 signature in a day one, and then show every day new signature.
I think they can. But there are some people who are genuine, so they will say ki maine signature kiya to ab koi nahi tha.
Exactly.
attendance sheet, whenever attendance sheet is generated, it has a particular barcode.
So attendance sheet is being sent from our side or they
generated.
They print.
It is generated dynamically.
I was thinking of actually doing some barcode, etc. But everything they can cheat.
Biometrics is the only way, and the verification should be done on server. So their biometric impression should be stored on server. They have to come put the thumbprint so that it will be verified by the server.
Face recognition is another thing.
So this is sort of attendance report that the remote center coordinator can see. We have added two new features in this part. That was the requirement here, that the total number of participants that can be generated that have attended the session on that particular day. So that is here the last row that it can be shown. The second feature that we have added is the total number of sessions that the participants attend and the percentage attendance of the participant. Those two features we have added in this part. Now, moving on to one of the most important parts that has been assigned to us of fetching the grades actually from IIT Bombay X. So, as we know, the online component is hosted on IIT Bombay X and the grades must be fetched from there. So, this is the basic structure of the interface, the process flow that I have understood and I can tell you that here in the center there is this T-Cube user interface. On the right hand side, the IIT Bombay X MySQL database, Mongo database, and here our T-Cube MySQL database. Now what happens is the course structure and the grading policy of the course on hosted online is stored in the Mongo database of IIT Bombay, while the actual marks for each participant and each question are stored in MySQL database. So we have to get the course structure from Mongo and get the actual marks from MySQL. So it has took a lot of time for me to understand. So this is basically.
Sorry. Why do you have to get the course structure?
Sir, the structure of the IIT Bombay X database is such that it stores the marks with a problem ID for each problem and each participant. So we have to filter it accordingly from MySQL. But these problem IDs are actually stored in the Mongo database only. So we have to get those problem IDs from Mongo database. And the Mongo database has this complex structure wherein it is a hierarchy.
First question is why Mongo they have used?
Whenever the course is generated.
Anything special support that they are getting from using the hybrid databases, or only for the sake of only passion, let's use somewhere mango, somewhere use raspberry, strawberry, orange.
Sir, whenever the course is generated, each course can have variable number of fields, variable number of questions, variable types of questions. So all this is variable and it cannot be directly stored in MySQL.
Why?
Because MySQL table is fixed. So we have to get the...
Create new table.
Sir, but if a particular field does not exist...
Create a field.
Sir, but it cannot be applicable to all the courses.
Why not? There are so many applications which are running on MySQL. Do you say that MySQL doesn't have the capability of handling such kind of structure? It is a too much complex structure that it is not acceptable for the MySQL to sustain the load? The thing is that whether you ask your mentor also ki why there are two databases, whether it is originally available, that is why you have taken, or you have worked out something?
Sir, it's actually the OpenIDX database structure that have that
they
is.
Okay. Right?
Okay.
But you should be able to answer the question why OpenIDX, why Mongo?
So,
there may be some reason why Mongo.
So not specifically, but they have created in sort of Mongo, they are they are distributing the data in three collections. So, and this is particularly important as they are using the active versions table to store the course definition, the structures table in which all these things are stored, the blocks, course, chapters and problems and definition. So this is not a fixed structure of a fixed rigid structure of a course. It gives the flexibility of generating the course as well as generating the types of questions that we want to add, types of modules that we want to add. So all this flexibility is actually given by the Mongo database.
Then let him present, his time is going on, don't interfere, right? This is you have to answer the question ki why Mongo. Then there is kind of flexibility what you are saying is whether it is not possible with other database like you are saying MySQL. That is what the question was.
Yeah, so exactly, sir, whatever I have understood from this part, both the databases.
No problem. If you don't know the answer, say that I don't know. It's not an issue, right? Sir, rather than giving the wrong answer, it is always good. I always suggest that case, except I don't know. It's sure. Fine.
Sir, I don't know the exact answer. I'm telling you that that for me it has been this much that the convenient Mongo convenience for course creation, that is the Mongo giving. So that is what I have understood from this. The next part is so this is a complex database structure and a hierarchy of a whole lot of blocks that they have made. So understanding this, so till now we have got this much till this much that we have created some participants for testing purpose in IIT Bombay X, and we are the marks here are for a particular email ID, since we know that email ID is unique between both TCube and IIT Bombay X, so we are using email ID and we are getting the marks for that structure. The marks shown are this final percentage marks of online component after applying all grading conditions from the grading policy that we are getting from IIT Bombay X. These marks have been mapped with TQ database using the unique email ID that we are getting. There is some improvement part that is still remaining in this, that we have to actually store this store these marks in the database and use forward it further to the for a certificate generation to get the actual grades to generate certificate. So that part is still remaining, and I'll be doing it in the next week. I'm here, so I'll be doing it.
Next we'll move on to the certificate module. In this, we will be generating the certificates for all the participants who have fulfilled the grading criteria. And whenever the principal delivery manager logs in, he will be able to see all the list of the active workshops. He can also switch to a particular workshop in which he will be able to see all the remote centers registered for the particular workshop. And in the left, there is a button download template. He can download the template for the face-to-face component to fill the marks, and then he'll upload it. After uploading the marks, he'll generate the marks for the participants. The admin can also see the participants in a particular workshop.
Okay. You are coming for a second time, right? So how many times you are going to come? This is the last time? Okay, thank you.